25 years after the first of his 6 UK titles, he's back as defending champion, hoping to make it a magnificent 7. 5 times a champion of the world, blink and you'll miss him, the Rocket, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Ronnie O'Sullivan's made it a true art form.
He's the best player who's ever played.
He was knocking in tons for fun when he was 10.
The greatest snooker player we've ever seen.
Great to watch, great to play against.
He's the greatest player that's ever picked a snooker cue up.
For pure and utter talent, there's never been anybody like him.
Ronnie's the best player that I've ever seen.
For 25 years, Ronnie O'Sullivan has loomed over the snooker landscape, the Mozart of his time, redefining what was considered possible. Like any genius, replete with all too human flaws. But what a statement the 17-year-old prodigy made at the UK Championship back in 1993.
It's a good one. 36. And now it's there for the taking. And he's made it himself.
Everyone had known about Ronnie for a long time. I think I played him in an exhibition when he was only 14. And you could see what he had straight away. You could see he had the gift.
Stephen Hendry will shake his hand. I know he admires Ronnie's play. We all do.
He played the kind of snooker that I love to watch. Obviously, it's hurtful when you're on the receiving end of it in a final. You could tell from long before that final what he was going to achieve in the game.
The following season came his second Triple Crown at the Masters and the start of a decades-long rivalry with John Higgins. Impish and impudent, there was an easy charm and magnetism about the young Ronnie, and he clearly revelled performing on the big stage.
When I look back over my career, I look at my proudest moments, and one of them was beating Ronnie in the 97 Masters final. And of course, there was a moment in that particular match. Bizarrely, a streaker came on, jumped over the set, and then bounced around all over the stage. It was Ronnie's turn at the table, and as he walked to the table, he just wiped the brow of John Street. It was a marvellous moment.
And always, those signature moments of brilliance.
134.
I don't believe this. Never forget that moment as long as I live, sitting in the commentary box and watching Ronnie O'Sullivan pop 15 reds, 15 blacks, all the colours, in 5 minutes and 20 seconds. Yeah. I can't see that record ever being beaten.
The Crucible, though, had never been the happiest of hunting grounds for the Rocket, and it took until 2001 for him to claim the first of his 5 world titles.
He said he didn't think he was ready to win until then. You know, he had to save his apprenticeship at the World Championship, said he missed a few balls. And it is a mental test there at Sheffield. He's done remarkably well to win it 5 times, and I'm pretty sure there's another one in there left. I mean, Steve Peters, who he's worked with mentally, has done a brilliant job with him.
But even though the wins kept coming, bubbling beneath the surface, there was the sense that this wizard was fighting his own demons.
I think if Ronnie was as mentally strong as he is now, he would have well overtook Stephen Hendry's world titles. And I'm pretty sure he lost lots of games at the Crucible where he just couldn't be bothered.
He's lost the belief. He's lost the belief.
Mental weakness becoming fatal flaws. As the erratic behaviour continued unabated, including moments of infamy here in York.
I had him. That's why the towel went over the place, because I had him. And I was playing well, and he was just trying to get me at it. Do what you like. You sit there, you just watch me keep playing and pop the balls, and you shake my hand. You get on the train or your car, and you go home, and I'll carry on in the tournament.
Things were going along very nicely. I was 4-1 ahead. Ronnie was in the balls and went for a bit of a tricky red and missed it by quite a way. So obviously I get out of my chair, I'm ready to play my shot, but he walks around and shakes my hand. You can tell by the look on my face that I just never had a clue this was going to happen. Obviously Ronnie had things that he was dealing with that obviously caused him to do this, because he's obviously never done it since.
But while that may have been an idea for O'Sullivan, barely a month later, the snooker world saw him at his very best. Not just in the state of his game as he inflicted a 10-3 demolition of Ding Junhui at the Masters, but perhaps more so because of the manner in which he consoled his visibly distraught opponent.
He wanted to do the right things and speak the right things to you. And every time we have a little chat, he's always speak right things.
The riddle, wrapped in a mystery, inside an enigma. But for those who know him well, the key has always been that constant quest for perfection.
Ronnie's the only player I've seen who goes out there and it's like, you know, if he gets his white an inch out of place or 2 inches out of place, you know, six shots later he can still be kicking himself in the head. And you just think, but you're potting balls and you're winning. It's like, well, you know, he says to me, he'd rather do a decent shot and lose than win and play badly.
Oh dear, oh dear.
Conceded, frame.
We've witnessed something this morning akin to a psychological collapse.
Standing on top of the world right where I want to be. So how can this dark cloud be raining over me?
The calming presence of Damien Hirst in his corner and the assistance of sports psychologist Steve Peters in more recent times has undoubtedly helped Ronnie to maintain his focus, particularly over those marathon 3 weeks in Sheffield. Back-to-back victories in 2012 and 13 saw him reach 5 Crucible triumphs, the latter despite him having taken a year's sabbatical from the sport.
Some people say you come back fresh as a daisy, but for someone to not play all year, not play a competitive game all year, and turn up and win the World Championship, that'd never be done again. Only he could do something like that. To watch him fly around the table like he does and make it look so effortless is, you can only just take your hat off to him and just admire him, really.
In 2017, Ronnie secured his record-breaking 7th Masters title. His opponent, Perry, made to look like just another ordinary Joe.
You know, if someone told me he was going to lose in a Masters final, then I'm glad it was against Ronnie, because that was an atmosphere like I'll probably never experience again. You know, I think if I was lucky enough to play him in a world final, I don't think it'd be like that. You know, London and the Masters, it's a special place. And the fact that I've lost in a Masters final and it was to Ronnie on a night like that, then I can sort of live with that.
And in this very arena last year, a record-equalling 6th UK title.
Anytime you play Ronnie O'Sullivan, it's a dream come true. It's a dream experience because you get to find out just where you are in relation to the greatest player that's ever picked up a snooker cue. It's a real stark lesson in this is where you need to be. This is the bar. Come join me. He keeps taking the game to new levels. He's on the cusp of 1,000 century breaks. That would have been unheard of and unthinkable just 5 or 10 years ago. And he really is an absolute genius on the table.
Clearly the fire still burns strong. There's a mental fortitude now and the man's still got game.
You're always looking for little signs when you're playing Ronnie. Is he getting a little bit temperamental? Is he getting annoyed with himself? And if he is, then you sort of G's you up a little bit. But he didn't look like that against me. He looked very focused. It didn't really bother about the score. And came back very, very strongly. And over the years, he has been a little bit frail, but doesn't seem to be. He seems to be in a good place mentally.
And now snooker history, 19 triple crowns. The record he shared with Stephen Hendry, now his and his alone. And just how many more could still be in store?
I sort of was quite happy with that quite quickly. I mean, first of all, it was the century breaks, then the maximums, ranking titles, then triple crowns, world titles. That might be the difficult one. But you never can tell, because I say, when Ronnie plays his best, he wins. As simple as that.
I've always said that Hendry's the scariest player I've ever played, but Ronnie's the best. And I'm not so sure Hendry's style of game would intimidate the players that are playing now, because he used to be very aggressive and almost leave you in the balls on purpose to make you collapse under pressure, whereas players these days don't collapse. They knock in 100 and say, thank you very much, Stephen. So Ronnie is just a master of the game, master safety player, master potter, break builder. He's the best.
25 years a pro, a quarter of a century of the sublime, and just occasionally the ridiculous. We've been truly blessed to have witnessed the age of O'Sullivan. Blinking, you'll miss him. It's the Rocket.